So let's say you're anxious about confrontation, but now you're anxious about being so anxious. And now that anxiousness is piling up, which causes, oh no, triple anxiety. Or let's say you're so worried about living up to your family's expectations of you. So naturally, you have high but unrealistic standards for yourself. And that worriness just piles up on and on and on again, and you're so stressed out. Wait, where did the worriness even come from again? If you've endured something like this, welcome to the feedback loop from hell. So what is the feedback loop from hell? Well, let's say that online, you're just mindlessly scrolling through social media and you see people vacationing in Hawaii, getting their dream job, getting their dream car. And while you're sitting down, scrolling on your couch, maybe you haven't showered in a week, or maybe you're just flossing your cat, and you just can't help but sit there and think that something is wrong with you, but nothing is wrong with them. So over the years, why has this feedback loop gotten so prominent? Well, it's all due to the lies of the internet. The idea that, oh, my life is better than yours and everything is perfect is a true motto, yet devastating motto of social media. And so when we think about things like these, we should learn to not compare ourselves from random strangers on the internet, because guess what? The internet and social media does not reflect reality accurately. On social media, all people do is post about their successes, their success stories, but people rarely talk about the failures and the multiple iterations that they had to do and endure in order to reach that one success story. And that's why we shouldn't believe in social media and that constant comparison, especially for the younger generations, with us versus the people on social media, people who've maybe attained a CS degree for an Ivy League college, or people who've gotten their dream Ferrari, or maybe even their dream cat. We shouldn't be constantly comparing ourselves to people online. And so you might be thinking, okay, well, Fatima, what is the solution to this? Well, actually, the solution is the simplest one. It's actually to simply not care. I know, right? That's crazy. Well, to simply not care means to simply not care about every itty-bitty, itsy-witsy thing that you think will impact your life. My dad actually told me this one really good quote that still resonates with me today. If it won't matter to you in 5 years, then there's no point wasting even 10 seconds thinking about it. And I've actually used that life motto in many of the things that I've worked on. Simply put, if you just see random people on the internet getting their dream job, getting their dream car, you say, oh, well, good for you. But I know that my life's path is different and I will attain success maybe in a different way than you. And that's the mindset that we all should be equipped with, especially the younger generations. Me as a Gen Zer, I used to compare myself online with people who have accomplished such amazing things, but you can't just sit there and constantly compare yourself. Instead, we should do something about it. And so much of this presentation was actually inspired by a quote by Mark Manson, and he says that the desire for more positive experience is itself a negative experience, and conversely, the acceptance of one's negative experience is in itself a positive experience. Well, what does this even mean? This sounds pretty confusing, right? Well, it was definitely confusing for me when I first read it. So let's break it down. Essentially, what this is saying is wanting more positive experience, such as love, happiness, a good, healthy relationship, desiring that actually results in a negative experience where you feel lonely and desolate and you feel like you're not good enough. Conversely, accepting these negative experiences, such as failure or making mistakes, actually leads to a positive experience where a person is overall more resilient and more capable and more confident in themselves, which is very, very important. Let me give you an example. So let's say there's a person, right? And if they want to be more rich and more rich, they will feel less satisfied and they'll actually feel more poor despite how much income they actually make. I know, it's crazy how the brain works. And another example would be that the more happier you want to be, the more desolate and the more lonely you actually will end up feeling, the more less satisfied you actually will end up feeling. And An example for accepting one's negative experience as a positive experience is, let's say you go to the gym to work out. Maybe you haven't gone to the gym in maybe a year, or you just went to the gym just yesterday. I know for me, every day, even if I do want to go to gym, I'm always like, no, today's not the day, I'll go tomorrow. But that's not the mindset you should be having. If you have, for example, the pain of hitting legs in the gym, all becomes worth it after that 30 minutes to an hour of a gym session where you feel so much more healthier than when you actually entered the gym. And that's all what this quote is essentially about. Accepting that pain, accepting those mistakes and those several failures before actually reaching a success story is what's really the key goal. And that's what actually relates directly to a positive experience. And when looking at these positive and negative experiences, it's also important not to deny failures and not to avoid them, because they are inevitable. And even the top engineers and technicians like Albert Einstein, Thomas Edison, Beyoncé even, they've gone through so many failures and non-successful endeavors to actually reach that success point. And social media and the internet doesn't really talk about that. Those failures that make up that one success story. And I feel like that's what's really most important. If you're able to bounce back from failure and be okay with failing, that's what's really going to take you to the top level. And that's what companies, CEOs, and young leaders are really looking for. People who are resilient, people who don't give up, and people who honestly just do their best. And so this actually also helps break the feedback loop from hell. Well, how? And how can we actually continue to break the feedback loop from hell? Well, what I'm about to say may sound a little bit counterintuitive, but don't try. I know, that sounds kind of weird, right? Like, Fatima, why wouldn't I try upon goals that I genuinely feel passionate about? Well, think about it this way. When you actually care less about a thing, you tend to do well. Here, let me give an example. So in my math class, we have practice tests before the actual test. And usually people tend to do much, much better on those practice tests compared to the actual test, even if the level of difficulty is around the same. Well, why is that? That's because on the actual test, people really, really try hard. And not necessarily trying is the problem, but the things, the negative emotions that come associated with trying, such as your stress level goes up, your anxiety level goes up, and you feel very, very pressurized. And all these negative emotions causes you to actually underperform, causes you to actually not do as well as you are capable of doing. Another example would be, let's say you're going to a volleyball championship game and you haven't played volleyball in years and $25,000 is on the line. You're more likely to do very bad at that game versus actually just playing a chill game of volleyball with your friends. And why is that? Because when that money's on the line and when you're playing in front of thousands of people, your stress level goes up, your anxiety level goes up. But if you kind of think about it in a nonchalant way and don't per se try, you get less anxious, less stress, and you feel more wavy in a way. And so when you feel that way, you actually tend to do much better at whatever you're accomplishing. And so if there's one thing I want you all to take away from this speech, is that don't try too hard. Don't try to impress anybody or do things just for other people. Do it for yourself, because in the end, you are the only one that matters. And you're the only one who's going to stick with you throughout your life. So you should be happy with all your decisions and never change yourself for anyone other than yourself. Thank you so much.